Here it is, the all-new 7.3-liter gas V8 engine that Ford is going to be introducing in the 2020 Ford Super Duty at the end of 2019. And in this video, we're going to dive deep into the design of this engine to see what makes it tick.
I'm Joel Beltramo. I'm the engineering manager for the all-new 7.3-liter gasoline engine.
This is an all-new engine. Nobody has seen this engine before.
No, it's new from the ground up. We took the wealth of information we've gathered from what our Super Duty and our various truck customers want for the future, and we designed an engine specifically for that. And so the engine, some people call it big block because it's not as small dimensionally internally as the small block engines. Mm-hmm. What that allows us to do is to be at 7.3 liters and extremely durable.
Can you explain what that means as far as big block feature of it?
It's really about the bore spacing. And so if you're thinking of light duty vehicles, F-150s, equivalent, those vehicles are very capable for what they're designed for. This engine, though, is not designed to be under 8,500 pounds. This is designed all the way up into the medium duty trucks. And so we need more space between the bores for cooling, for the structural durability. That structure exists through the whole cylinder block. And by being big block, it moves some of the bores for the pistons slightly farther apart, allows us more structure in there. Very simple thing like main bearing caps. You've heard people talk about 4-bolt mains. This engine has 4 bolts vertically plus 2 cross bolts. So there's 6 bolts per main cap.
Okay.
It's an iron block, very, very durable design. Now, as much as we talk about how big it is, the interesting thing is physically, it's actually very narrow.
Okay.
And so
why is that?
We set out, that's part of the reason why we went with the camshaft and block. Okay. So that allows us to shrink down the width of the engine. And on the surface, you'd say, well, why? But the thing is, for Ford, we have a whole bunch of commercial truck customers, and they demand the best in terms of durability and efficiency. By shrinking down the width of the package, we can put essentially the same power plant in a whole range of vehicles. And so by doing that, if you're running a fleet, that means you're not trying to have different power plants. What do I need to do service? What training do I need? It's the same engine over and over again.
So no matter a commercial truck versus a more of a consumer-oriented Super Duty?
From the F-250 up, yeah. The engines are almost the exact same. There's some subtle differences for the chassis, F-250, F-350, but then the dyno certs are almost identical across all the other commercial trucks and the Super Duty.
Why 7.3?
So on the surface, as we deal with the newer fuel economy standards, and we think cars, we think about people downsizing, boosting, that kind of stuff. And that makes a lot of sense for vehicles that are normally run light loaded. But when you come to the larger truck business, these are work trucks. They're carrying payloads every day. So what we wanted to do for our customers is a couple things. One, obviously clean for the environment with emission rules. The second thing is being more fuel efficient. And when you want to be fuel efficient, the best place to run the engine is at stoichiometric air-fuel mixture. That means a perfect amount of fuel-to-air ratio.
Okay.
And so when you do that, in theory, it limits how much power you can make compared to enrichment. And so what we did is we designed this engine to run stoichiometric, and we know how much power our customers need. So we took that stoichiometric point you can run, and we calculated what displacement it takes to deliver to our customers the efficiency and the power at the same point.
Okay.
And when you do that, it calculates out as 7.3 liters.
Okay.
So we're in a position, because it's all new, we could have gotten bigger, we could have gotten smaller. 7.3 liters, we think, is the right answer for true commercial customers that are hauling payloads every day.
Unfortunately, we don't have the power specs on the new 7.3 liter, but Ford says it's gonna slot literally in the middle between the 6.2 liter gas engine and the capability of the 6.7 liter turbo diesel. So you can expect a lot of torque from this gas engine down low, but we still don't have the exact numbers.
Do you have the power ratings right now?
We're not ready to disclose them, but it will be a step up from our current powertrains, and we think that it'll be quite a nice added capability when you think F-250, F-350.
And this engine is designed to match with the 10-speed, is that right?
So it was designed from the start knowing about the 10-speed, knowing what the gear ratios were. Then, beyond that, the control system. We talk so much about electronics and user, interfaces. It's really important when you talk about optimizing how an engine runs This engine, you know, it has VCT, it has variable displacement oil pump. All this is optimized knowing what the transmission is going to be. So we didn't go design a transmission, design an engine over here, buy a control system somebody. Ford designed all that together. And so it's a collective powertrain system, including controls.
And this is a push rod, is that right?
Yeah, it's a push rod that gets us our compactness. Now, part of the reason why we favor push rod for this particular engine is being the class it's going into, these engines don't run at extremely high speed.
Engine speed. Right.
And so if you're gonna be running, we'll say 6,000 plus, overhead cam has some definite advantages. At the lower engine speeds, the push rod, you sacrifice some of the ultimate capability of a four valve, okay? But being push rod, it's much more compact. It is optimized to run the way our customers actually use them. And so in the over 14,000 and in the F-250s and F-350s where you're running them hard, this engine's designed to be very efficient there. The other thing it brings in is because the engine's narrower this way, what that means is if you think about your grill opening, you got all the cooling air coming over your radiator, more airflow can go alongside the engine because it's narrower, which helps keep the whole underhood a bit cooler. As we look at the exhaust systems, you know, first up, instead of just your traditional simple log manifold, the short wheel runner, the runners are designed both for length and shape to maximize torque. Okay. Because at the end of the day, that's one of the critical things if you're pulling a trailer, right? The ability to accelerate it, not have to downshift every time if you just want to pick up a little speed on the freeway. The exhaust manifolds, when we're looking at the DynoCert versions, they are made of cast stainless steel, and so extremely durable. Beyond that, we have very, very tough tests we run. We call it the GET test, Global Exhaust Thermal Test.
Okay.
And that test is designed to thermal stress the manifolds more severely than you can in a vehicle. What we do is we heat it up to its maximum temperature, then we quench it. And we do that over and over again.
With water or
actually
throwing water on it?
No, we actually pump cold air through it.
Oh, okay.
And so what happens is we know how those thermal cycles compare to when you're running, let's say, down the freeway and you hit puddles and standing water gets kicked up, or your emergency vehicle and you're having to cross some standing water, sure, you know, as you go in. So we have those tests. They've been developed over, you know, quite a period of time. They've proven very, very well on like our 6.7 diesel. Well, when we went into medium duty trucks, we lengthened that test. This engine is the first gas engine we have that can pass that test at medium duty distance. And so the exhaust manifolds are very tough, intended for the severe use that the vehicles will see. Mm-hmm. You asked about the fuel system.
Yeah.
This engine's PFI, okay, so it's port fuel injected. Okay. We went that way because we can deliver the fuel economy with all the optimization we did in the rest of the engine. So this is a case where we could have gone DI. Ford obviously uses DI on many engines.
Sure.
But in this case, we put a lot of technology actually into the engineering, so we didn't have to put that piece of technology in for the customer to pay for. And so we get the fuel economy that's required with PFI due to the overall engineering we did on the total engine. It's part of the reason why 7.3 liters was such an important answer, is by optimizing the engine displacement to exactly what the customer needs. You don't have to buy other things to try to reach to the displacement it should have been.
Okay. Tell me a little bit more about the cylinder and the piston. How's that designed?
So, you know, at this point, Ford's doing a lot of turbo diesel engines, which are some of the highest pressure engines. We're doing EcoBoost, the turbocharged gasoline engines. This engine uses a mixture of technologies. So I don't think you can get a picture, but in here there's an oil cooling jet that actually squirts oil up underneath the piston.
Okay.
So the underside of the piston crown is contoured for the fact that we're going to be cooling with the jet. And so that cools the piston. Some simple things is if you looked at the output of the engine, the top ring would be just kind of a traditional piston ring. In this engine, we're using the same anti-wear materials that we use in turbocharged engines. Okay, some of the highest temperature capability, even though we're not going to run the engine to that level of heat, because the thing about this engine, it's got to be durable. And so there's a number of materials in the rings. If we were to look at the valve seats and valves, materials in those parts are actually sufficient to be used in turbocharged engines. And so once again, the, you know, from high level, you might say, I don't see the technology. But when you look at the individual parts, the technology is put in for durability and fuel economy. And so there's very specific usages. Some of the standard things, roller valve train.
So this is the push rod, is that correct?
So here's your camshaft. There's a VCT on the other end. We have a roller valve train. We're using very special bearing materials in this valve train that other companies don't use. The reason for that is both durability and friction. And so then you standard push rod, rocker arm, once again with another bearing up here. So your points where you would have friction are supported by roller bearings. You know, standard, you know, springs and valve geometry. The ports, as you can see from some of these sections, are designed for very high flow. So once again, the engine's designed to be able to supply very good performance for its displacement.
And also down low, you're saying. So it's important at lower RPMs to deliver that.
Yes, because, you know, in the once again, the heavier trucks, you're typically not going to run...
Racing them down the street.
No,
right?
but you've got to be able to start that load on a grade. And so as tempting as it would be if you're building a race engine or whatever, you just make it rev up. This engine, it's got to be able to start out that load. And so, you know, at the very high gross combined weights that the Super Duties will be at, it's important to have a lot of torque down low. Now, because of the nature of how much power it makes, it also does make quite a bit of torque farther up in RPM range, but it is strong from where the torque converter starts to engage all the way across the power band.
Cool. So basically, the 6.2 liter V8 is still there, right, in the Super Duty. And this could fit, like you said, in the same form factor as that engine.
This engine is slightly longer than a 6.2.
Okay.
It's narrower.
Okay.
So the 6.2 will carry on as a base engine in Super Duty. This will be a significant step up into a segment that, frankly, I don't see anybody in right now. This is going to start to close some of the gap. If you think between our highly capable 6.7, just what it can do in trailer tow, this will give a gas offering that can have very strong trailer tow performance without having to take that next step into the diesel.
So while this video was totally focused on the new gas V8 engine from Ford, we also have a video on the TFL Truck channel that talks about all the new features of the new 2020 Super Duty. And you can go back to tfltruck.com for more news, views, and real-world truck reviews.